It seems to me that a great deal of success in the businesses that you guys are involved in revolves around two facts. A, knowing how your staff ticks, their preferences, their intentions, their motivations. And B, knowing how your customers tick, their preferences, their intentions, their motivations. And if you can satisfy both, you're probably communicating safety to them, and all of a sudden, you're in my world. So we have perhaps something that we can talk about. I believe this is especially valuable knowledge when there is conflict and change, because you and your colleagues are going to have to know how to mediate one and roll with the other. So if you can keep your grump factor on, we're going to talk a little bit about the concept of, well described in the research literature, theory of mind. Here it is. It's in two parts. The first part of theory of mind is this. It's the ability to peer inside someone else's head and understand the rewards and punishment systems inside that head with very few nonverbal cues. It's close to mind reading. There's no mind reading. Brains can't read each other's minds, but you can read each other's intentions and motivations if you have a strong gadget, behavioral gadget, we call theory of mind. The granular part of that is simply the rewards and punishment systems. The second second characteristic of theory of mind is this. It's the ability to understand at all times that the rewards and punishment systems you're seeing inside someone else's head, we call that the conspecific, by the way, the rewards and punishments you see in the conspecific's head are not the same ones in your head. They don't react like you do because you are not the center of their universe. They are the center of your universe. That make sense? I call it John Medina's second law of marriage. What is obvious to you is obvious to you.